Hey, so I just got back from a month-long trip through Europe, and I'd just like to say thanks for your patience and the wait is over. Traveling through Europe, there was something I noticed a lot of. Lions. Not real living lions, of course, but lion statues, or even just symbols of lions, can be found everywhere here. For someone in Europe, this might feel normal, but if you stop and think about it, it's sort of strange. Out of the 50 countries in Europe today, 17 of them feature lions in some way in their national emblems. Belgium, which actually has the most with 13 lions on it, Bulgaria, Czechia, Denmark, Estonia, Finland, France, though these are really only on French passports and a few other places, Georgia, Latvia, Luxembourg, Montenegro, the Netherlands, Norway, Romania, Spain, Sweden, and the United Kingdom. Beyond this, it's often lions that guard the pathways to large government buildings or palaces, it's lions which hold door knockers and doorbells, and it's lions that are sculpted above doorways and even into the sides of buildings as decorations. This tradition isn't new either, and even the Mycenaeans, the first people group to ever show signs of an advanced civilization in all of Europe, have as their oldest surviving monument what's called the Lion's Gate, which, you guessed it, is a sculpture of two lions above a gateway which is over 3,000 years old, showing just how long and how prevalent lions have been featured in European architecture and art. Many family crests also contain lions, and even my own family's crest has a couple lions in it, despite being originally from Ireland. Even in modern times, lions are now being used as symbols for brands and companies all over Europe, ensuring that they remain part of the iconography here for years to come. But what's strange isn't that pictures of lions are all over Europe, it's that out of the 50 or so countries of Europe, a total of 0 countries have a native lion population. They just don't live here. As it stands now, the modern range of wild lions looks like this, meaning that lions today are found entirely within Africa. And yet, this completely foreign animal has made its way onto some of the most important images of a country, like their coat of arms and their flags. This would be like if the United States coat of arms featured a panda on it, or if Canada's flag had a palm leaf on it. They're sort of just out of place here. So why can images of African lions be found all over Europe? Well, this question actually has 2 answers, really. First, while Europe has no native lions today, this hasn't always been the case, and in fact, at least 2 lion species have had native ranges in Europe while humans have lived here. Panthera leo, what we consider the modern African lion, once had a range that looked like this. Across West and Southern Europe, the whole of Africa, and far into Asia, going as deep as the southern tip of India. Besides Panthera leo, however, there was also another species of lion, Panthera spelia, also known as the Eurasian cave lion. These are sort of the winter weather version of modern lions. I guess in the same way you could say mammoths are the winter weather version of the modern day elephant. These lions had no manes around their neck and were up to 10% larger than the modern Panthera leo. Due to their larger size and dense undercoat of fur, these lions were capable of spreading far throughout Eurasia, even during the Ice Ages, from Europe all the way through Russia, across Beringia, and even into the Americas. This explains why in sites like Lascaux, France, where all of those really old but well-preserved cave paintings come from, images of lions can be found besides those of more typical animals. And while these paintings are from 17,000 years ago, evidence of lion-human interactions in Europe go back even further. A lion-headed ivory carving found in Germany can be seen depicting a lion's head atop a human's body. This figure dates back to at least 35,000 years ago, which roughly overlaps with when humans first began to live in Europe. This lion man figure is so old in terms of humanity that it is actually the earliest known example of a zoomorphic or an animal-shaped sculpture in the world, and it was a creature that was half lion, half man from Europe. This means that for as long as humans have been in Europe, minus modern times, lions were not only present but common throughout, and roamed the continent the same way they do in Africa to this day. Panthera spelia, however, started to go extinct in Europe roughly 14,000 years ago, right around when humans began to re-enter Europe after the last glacial maximum. It appears that, like other megafauna such as the mammoth and saber-toothed tiger, with a changing climate and an influx of disruptive humans, Panthera spelia was no longer able to survive. This left Panthera leo, modern-day lions. While better suited for warmer climates, the Panthera leo's time here was limited as well, mostly due to the presence of humans, but by around 1 CE, lions could still be found in South and Western Europe. And this is where we'll find our second reason for why lions are so popular across Europe today, the Romans. While the Greeks and others before definitely created lion imagery in places where the lions were to be found and depicted them in important stories like that of Heracles, the Romans adopted the image as a signifier of power, placing them before palaces and in public spaces to impress those who would come and see them. The Romans also began taking lions from other parts of their empire and bringing them back to Rome. It was lions taken from Greece that were used in their gladiatorial arenas, while it was lions from their northern African territories that the Romans took for something known as lion baiting, basically where they'd have a dog or a pack of dogs fight a lion to the death for sport. And as the Roman Empire spread, their symbol of the lion as a symbol for power spread with them. Despite being native to only a few places within the Roman Empire, the image of a lion became common wherever the Romans expanded into, regardless of whether or not any lions were actually native to the area anymore. Then, as human populations in Europe grew, Panthera leo gradually became extinct in these areas, remaining in places like Bulgaria until around the 4th or 3rd centuries BCE, and were found in Greece up until the 4th century CE. What was left behind was a symbol to the ancient Europeans, a symbol of power and royalty created by the Romans. And despite the fact that it's been entirely exterminated, the legacy of the European lion carries on in the banners, emblems, and flags of Europe, as a reminder that only one thing could displace such a mighty creature: us. Hey, so I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you live in Europe, I challenge you to look out for some lions and send me any good ones over on Twitter. All of the footage of lion statues I used in this video came from my trip through Europe, where I was basically on the lookout for lions at all times. It made the trip a lot of fun, but I definitely missed some, so again, send any that you find to me, I'd really like to see them. If you would like to see more videos like this, you should check out my Patreon, where you can donate money and get your name up here like all these people, who were so kind to be my patrons even while I was away. If you haven't subscribed, well, do that as well to see more videos like this coming soon. The next video skips ahead a little to when I visited Venice, so stay tuned for that. Thanks!